Hello, my name's Simon Crafer. We're in Italy, in Mezzano, as you can see, in the Monster Energy Yamaha garage with the bike of Frankie Morbidelli. Actually, I think if you look down there, he's in a debrief with his team right now. And I've decided this week's Tech Talk is about brakes, thanks to a few fan questions after the Austrian race, you know, with the big 355mm discs, you know, with the cooling slots. And I've convinced my old mate Ian Gilpin here, who works on Frankie's bikes, to show us the difference between like the more traditional size, like 320mm diameter, that is on the superbikes, the big stock thousands, for example, up to 320s, and how much easier it is to work on them and what they have to do now with the big 355s and 340s. So if you could, sounds like they're doing some serious mods to Fabio's machine over there. Thanks for your time. Ian, can you talk us through or show us now the 320s and how you could actually get the caliper out from the wheel? And if you could run around there, if you might want to have a look around here. And it's so much easier, as you'll see, with the smaller diameter disc, even the caliper comes out, you know, traditionally like a superbikes do, stock bikes, come out of there, okay, with a 320. And if you have a look around the other side, Ian's going to show us around here. On this side, look at this beautiful big 355mm across, the slots in it. The caliper doesn't come out, so they have a quick release. So it doesn't come out, it hits the wheel. Quick release, look at that. So the line is off the caliper, doesn't let any air in, special fitting. And then the whole wheel needs to come out, discs off, to be able to change, you know, the wheel and the tire. So it's a lot more work, even though these guys are pretty geared up for it. And Ian's got a couple of discs here, the 320. And so the 320, the 355. If you put the 320 on top there, Ian, just so they can see how much bigger, that's what we're talking about, the diameter, 320mm, 355. But also you'll notice, if we get there, there is high mass pads and the low mass pads. So meaning the amount, that the size that they push on the disc, you know, it's all the same material, all carbon fiber, but it pushes on a bigger area here than there. The reason it doesn't push on a bigger area, I asked, you know, that why don't you just go bigger and bigger? Because they have made it very precise on, thanks for that, buddy. Well, made it very precise on what pressure and feel that the riders need, what temperature it creates. We'll get back to temperature on the disc. So if they go too big, they're going to need a lot more pressure, not enough temperature, so they have to work that out exactly. Ian, there's also, if you could talk through for the viewers, the covers you have to run, speaking of temperature.
Yeah, we have four different style of covers now. Short cover, which is basically we'll probably use here because it's still quite warm. And medium-sized brake.
When you say short cover,
it's a half cover. It just covers half the disc.
Yep.
And then we have a full cover for cold conditions like Phillip Island.
Yep.
Or Silver.
And it's not too hard to break in at Phillip Island as well.
Phillip
and it gets
Island,
cold.
We tend to use 320 discs. The only racetrack left where we use 320s.
Because it's more flowing than
there's
brakes.
No, yeah. Hard braking, and there's no. It's normally quite cold.
And the places that the big 355s will be used?
355 we use in Austria and probably Japan.
Okay,
Otegi. Hard braking also.
Yeah. And 340s? Are they?
340s generally is a standard size now.
Okay, to take
everywhere.
Okay. Awesome. Hey, hope you've enjoyed. Thanks for your time, Ian. Really appreciate it. A little bit of info on the discs, what's used now, and we'll see you at the next race for the next Tech Talk. Bye for now.